Inshallah ta'ala, tonight's program is about the beauty and the miracle of Zamzam water. We are in the blessed month of Zulhajj, the month in which millions of Hujjaj have made the once-in-a-lifetime journey to Makkah and Medina Sharif in order to complete the pillar of Islam. We know very well that one part of this journey, an essential part of this journey, is to drink Zamzam water. And we who are unfortunate not enough to have completed the Hajj this year, we eagerly wait for the Hujjaj to return, our friends, our relatives and our family, so that we too can eat the dates of Medina Sharif and to drink the Zamzam of Makkah Sharif. So this program, I think, is a beautiful timing, a reminder of how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with this great miracle. Zamzam water comes from the best possible source, and that is the feet of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a living miracle till the day of judgment. It is totally different to all water on earth as proven by modern science. And these same scientists, many of them non-Muslims, have all unanimously agreed that this is the purest water on God's earth. And scientific research certainly has indicated that. It is a miracle of Allah, not least when we consider where Zamzam water is actually coming from. It's coming from a country where there are no lakes, where there are no rivers, where there are no reservoirs, no streams. A place where water is more expensive than oil. And this well, a small well measuring only by 18 foot by 14 foot, perhaps for the last 3,000-4,000 years, has been providing water for all of the Hujjaj. You know very well that when people go to Mecca and when they return from Hajj and Umrah, how much Zamzam they actually return with. We're talking of billions of gallon. And it's all coming from one simple source, and yet it has not decreased, and inshallah ta'ala, till the day of judgment, it will not decrease. To begin with then, let us talk about the history of Zamzam water. We know very well that the story of Zamzam relates to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam and his family. Ibrahim alayhi salam was asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to migrate to Makkatul Mukarramah with his wife Sayyida Hajira and his small son Sayyidina Ismail. He at the time was only very, very small, he was an infant. At the time, Makkah Sharif was basically a barren desert in a valley. There was certainly no water there. There was no population and hardly any greenery. As soon as they reached Makkah Sharif, and they reached the area where we know that the Kaaba Sharif is, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam left Sayyida Hajira and Sayyidina Ismail there and began to walk off in the horizon. Hajira alayhi salam called out that, "Ya Ibrahim, you are walking away and deserting us. Why are you doing that? We have a small child here." Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam did not respond. A second call came from Sayyida Hajira that, "Oh Ibrahim, this is scorching hot desert, there is no food here, there is no water. Why are you deserting your own family?" Again, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam gave no response. And perhaps partly because of the lack of response from Sayyidina Ibrahim, Hajira alayhi salam understood that this must be a hukam and a command from Allah. And so she asked, full of wisdom and hikmah, and she asked Sayyidina Ibrahim, that is this an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to leave us here? To which Sayyidina Ibrahim finally responded and said, yes. Sayyidina Hajira then replied, "Izan la yudi'una Allah. If that is the case, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look after us. He will never let any of us perish." And then from that, you know the story thereafter, that Ismail alayhi salam began to cry. Sayyida Hajira frantically searched for water. She ran between the mountains of Safa and Marwa 7 times, from which we get the ritual of Sa'i that we perform on the Hajj and Umrah. As he was crying, he was digging his heels into the ground, from which Zamzam water began to gush forward. One reported that it wasn't Sayyidina Ismail's heels, rather it was the wings of Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam, the archangel, who came down and allowed that water to gush. Either way, from that moment, it might have been 3, might have been 4, might have been longer, 1,000 years ago. From that same spot, Zamzam water has emitted, and inshallah ta'ala will continue to emit until the day of judgment.